welcome to the paradise island of Sri Lanka. So after lunch, I decided to go down to the beach and have a look at Negombo beach and see how the beach is. And I've been noticing that the first couple of days that I've been here, there's not really been that much people on the beach. So I spoke to some of the locals and they said that after what happened a couple of weeks ago, there has been no people at the beach at all. And of course there's no tourists on the beach either, so there's no point of all the people who sell stuff at the beach to be there either. So the beaches has been really, really empty since I came. I've been here for a week now. So I decided to head out and have a look at the beach and see how Negombo beach, what Negombo beach looks like. On the way down to the beach, there's a lot of shops on the roads, and they sell all kind of different stuff. And the area here is really, it's a Christian area, so there's a lot of Christian people living here. And all around and alongside the roads, there are these kind of places. There's a lot of small alleys that leads down to the beach. Mostly the road to the beach are covered by restaurants, so you have to go through a restaurant, but every once in a while you find one of these small alleys that leads down to Negombo beach. It was a lovely day, so the beach looked amazing. And as you can see, there's some people now. There's some people going back to the beach. And another local guy told me that this is really the first time after what happened that there had been some people on the beach. And also this weekend was the birth of Buddha. So this weekend is really, really big for the Buddhist people, and they celebrate. And this weekend they had many of them have a day off, and Monday was also a holiday, so many people decided to go down to the beach and enjoy the sea. And it was so nice to see so many people gathering again and celebrating, just enjoying life. Of course, the military was there standing and checking everybody who entered the beach, and there was military on the beach, and I didn't really want to film those guys, but there were a lot of military on the beach as well. But as you can see, there was also a lot of people. But this is also the biggest celebration time for the Buddhists. So I understand. Even though there were some talks about that they shouldn't really gather in big crowds again. But right now, it feels, even though I've just been here for a week, it feels like things are going back to the normal already. That's just my impression, but that's the impression I have right now. That people are starting to relax a bit again. the tourists. I've seen more tourists the last couple of days than I have been seeing for the whole stay. So they are definitely coming back already. Not maybe as much as before, but they are starting to come back again. And on the beach there were a lot of nice small vendors where you could buy some fresh seafood, crabs and shrimps and french fries and small snacks. We have the ice cream cars and people really seem to enjoy themselves. I almost got run over by tuk-tuk. You see a lot of these old buses. And the birds. These crows. Or ravens, I think they're crows. Or ravens, I'm not sure. They are everywhere. Everywhere, and they get really, really up and close. But as you can see, it was a beautiful, beautiful day. And people were playing these instruments, singing. They were also doing other stuff. I don't really know what they were doing, but they seemed to enjoy themselves. In the background here, I don't know if that's Colombo or if that is Negombo City. I haven't been that far yet, but I can definitely see some kind of quite big city in the distance. I have to explore that. There's also a really nice park where people sit and relax. Very peaceful and very quiet. And like everywhere else, the Western world has made an impact. You have juice bars and so I headed home for a quick dinner, and then I decided to go back down to the beach for a beach run in the evening. Every evening I try to do a beach run. I run from one side of the beach to the other side. It takes about, from where I am, back and forth, about 40 minutes if you run all the way. And all along the beach you could see people playing games. They were playing volleyball, catch, football and soccer, and of course cricket. Every day when I run, I see a lot of people standing just fishing from the seashore. And I was lucky enough to see some guys catching some fish. And I believe I spoke a little bit to the guy and he said it was a catfish, if I don't mistaken. And the sunset was just beautiful this day. Here you can see the guys playing cricket. Cricket, of course, is a very big sport in Sri Lanka. And there were the guys also playing football. I haven't had the courage yet to go and ask them if I can join, but I've been standing there for a while just looking at them. And I think one day they will ask me if I want to play. We'll see how it goes. Life is just very slow here in Sri Lanka, and I really, really like it. The tempo is slow, everything happens slow, and it's just like Asia in general. When you get to these little bit smaller places, life is easy, life goes slow, and you just enjoy the moment. I'm gonna stay a couple of more days in Negombo. I met some really nice people at the hostel that I'm staying. I told myself that maybe I'm not the hostel person I was before when I was traveling when I was younger, but a hostel is a perfect place to meet other people. And we had one German girl that I spoke a lot with, and we did some stuff together, and we also had another German couple who stayed there for a couple of nights and had some really great conversations with them. And this morning, a Japanese girl, she just left for candy. So you meet a lot of people when you stay in a hostel, and I'm really enjoying the conversations that I have with them. Just sitting up here on the rooftop and just talking about life. I'm really, really enjoying it so far. Thank you so much for watching. And if you would like to share this video on your Facebook or on your social media, I would be so thankful. Thank you so much for watching. Bye bye.